Welcome, dear student, to this module of E-Pathshala on omega-3 and omega-6 fatty acids as functional foods. Fats and lipids are an important constituent in human diet, and fat is the only source of food which provides the highest kilocalories among all the foods consumed. Fats and lipids have numerous functions in our body, like digesting, absorbing, transporting nutrients like fat-soluble vitamins, protecting bones from mechanical pressure, helping in the utilization of phytochemicals such as lycopenes and carotenoids, and many others. Fats have always been criticized because a high intake leads to obesity, which is a forerunner of many diseases. But fatty acids have certain functional properties and are vital for mental and physical functions of the body. Omega-3 and omega-6 category of fats have been proved to provide numerous benefits to promote health. Gain knowledge on the omega-3 and omega-6 fatty acids' nature, structure, sources, and understand the importance of these two fatty acids in promoting health as functional food. Unlike carbohydrates, which are polymers, lipids are small molecules and are classified into simple, compound, and miscellaneous lipids. As you can see in this chart, fatty acids are simple lipids. They occur rarely, free in nature, and are almost always linked to other molecules by their hydrophilic carboxylic acid head group. Fatty acids consist of a chain of carbon atoms with a methyl group at one end and an acid group at the other. Each carbon atom has a number of hydrogen atoms attached to it. The exact number of hydrogen atoms on each carbon depends on whether the fat is saturated or an unsaturated fat. Saturated fatty acids contain the maximum level of hydrogen atoms possible, while in unsaturated fatty acids, some of the hydrogen atoms are missing and have been replaced with double bonds between the carbon atoms. The fat is termed monounsaturated if there is one double bond, and polyunsaturated if there are two or more double bonds. Based on the placement of the carbons within a fatty acid, they are referred to as alpha, beta, and omega. Alpha refers to the first carbon adjacent to the carboxyl group, beta to the second, and omega to the last carbon. As you are able to see in the slide, the omega-3 and omega-6 differ in the location of the first double bond. In omega-3 fatty acids, the first double bond occurs on the third carbon atom, but in omega-6 fatty acids, the first double bond is on the sixth carbon atom, counting from the methyl end, denoted as omega. Both omega-3 and omega-6 fatty acids are important components of cell membranes and are precursors to many other substances in the body, such as those involved with regulating blood pressure and inflammatory responses. There is increasing support for omega-3 fatty acids in protecting against fatal heart disease, and it is known that they have anti-inflammatory effects. There is also growing interest in the role of omega-3 fatty acids in the prevention of diabetes and certain types of cancer. Omega-3 and omega-6 fatty acids cannot be synthesized by humans and hence have to rely on dietary sources for these. The human body is capable of producing all the fatty acids it needs except for two, which is linoleic acid and omega-6 fatty acid and alpha-linolenic acid, which is an omega-3 fatty acid. These have to be consumed from the diet and are hence termed as essential fatty acids. Both of these fatty acids are needed for growth and normal functioning. Moreover, they can also be used to make other fatty acids. For example, arachidonic acid is formed from linoleic acid. However, as conversion to the omega-3 fatty acids, eicosapentaenoic acid and docosahexaenoic acid is limited, it is recommended that sources of these are also included in the diet. Let us first see about omega-3 fatty acid. The three types of omega-3 fatty acids involved in human physiology are alpha-linolenic acid or ALA, eicosapentaenoic acid EPA, and docosahexaenoic acid, which is DHA. Marine algae and phytoplanktons are primary sources of omega-3 fatty acids. Common sources of plant oils containing the omega-3 ALA fatty acid include walnut, edible seeds, sage seed oil, and flaxseed oil. The sources of animal omega-3 EPA and DHA fatty acids include fish and fish oils. Now let us see the different sources of omega-3 fatty acids. The chart you see here gives you an idea of omega-3 content seen in 100 gram of edible portion. Now as you can see, sardines and mackerel contain the highest among the fishes. As you can see here, sardines contain the highest amount of omega-3 fatty acids, that is DHA 22.6 and EPA 20:5. The next in line is mackerel, which contains 2.5 of omega-3 fatty acids, followed by herring, which is 1.6, salmon, which is 1.4, anchovy again 1.4, salmon from Atlantic Oceans 1.2, bluefish 1.2, pink salmon which has an omega-3 fatty acid of 1, followed by tuna, which is a very commonly consumed fish which contains 0.5 of omega-3 fatty acids, followed by trout, shrimp, catfish and lobster, where the fatty acids range from 0.2 to 0.4. Haddock and flounder fishes contain 0.2 of omega-3 fatty acids. Let us move on to see the importance of omega-3 fatty acids. Omega-3 lowers the risk of sudden death. Studies have shown that omega-3 fatty acids significantly reduce the risk of sudden death caused by cardiac arrhythmias and mortality among people who have cardiovascular disease. They also reduce blood clot formation. Omega-3 fatty acids act as a natural anticoagulant and thereby alter the ability of the platelets in the blood to clump together. The third is they are able to inhibit the growth of plaque. Thickening and hardening of the arteries leads to formation of plaques, and these leads to cardiovascular diseases. Omega-3 fatty acids help to keep the lining of the arteries smooth and clear, and thereby prevent the damage of arteries, which hastens the deposition of plaques that can lead to cardiovascular diseases. Omega-3 fatty acids are also good in decreasing triglycerides. We know that hypertriglyceridemia is associated with an increased risk for heart disease, and omega-3 fatty acids decrease the rate at which triglycerides are produced in the liver and thus help to lower triglyceride levels. They also increase levels of the good cholesterol or high density lipoprotein. Because omega-3 fatty acids lower triglyceride levels, they may also increase HDL or the good cholesterol that protects against the development of heart diseases. Omega-3 fatty acids also have anti-inflammatory properties. The development of atherosclerosis, which is hardening of the arteries, is involved with the body's inflammatory response. Omega-3 fatty acids reduce the production of substances that are released during the inflammatory response and thus help to prevent substances from accumulating and sticking to the lining of the arteries. Omega-3 also help in lowering blood pressure. Several studies have shown the effect of omega-3 fatty acids in lowering blood pressure. That is why we see those who eat fish tend to have a lower incidence of hypertension. So now you know that omega-3 are heart friendly and minimize the risk towards cardiovascular diseases. Let us see what will happen if there is a deficiency of omega-3 fatty acid. Well, an individual who is deficient in omega-3 fatty acids grows and reproduces normally but is at risk for developing learning problems and impaired vision because the human brain, central nervous system, and membranes throughout the body require omega-3 fatty acids, especially eicosapentaenoic acid and docosahexaenoic acid, for optimum function. Abnormal omega-6 and omega-3 ratios brings about changes in lipid composition of the vascular membrane and increases the incidence of atherosclerosis and inflammatory disorders. Some of the symptoms of deficiency of omega-3 fatty acids are mental effects. A large body of experimental evidence indicates that omega-3 fatty acids have significant effects on mental health. Depression, anxiety, postpartum depression, schizophrenia, and bipolar disorder have been linked to deficiency of omega-3 fatty acids. Problems with memory have also been linked to deficiencies in omega-3 fatty acids. Now the next one is dermatological changes. Dermatological problems such as dry, itchy skin, flaky skin, discolored patches of skin or rash may be due to low levels of omega-3 fatty acids. The skin may also become oily in patches and may take on a rough, bumpy appearance. Hair and nail problems like scanty hair or brittle nails are also caused by deficiency of omega-3. Now, the last symptom which occurs due to omega-3 deficiency is fatigue, intense menstrual cramps, and premenstrual breast pain, which have also been reported among women who have a deficiency of omega-3. Hence, in general, you must have noticed that omega-3 is linked to brain and heart health. Now that we have finished with omega-3 fatty acids, let us move on to omega-6 fatty acids. Omega-6 fatty acid is one with the first double bond located at the sixth carbon from the methyl end. The example is linoleic acid. Sources of omega-6 fatty acids. Omega-6 fatty acids are found in abundance in many commonly eaten foods such as in canola, sunflower, corn, olive, soybean and peanut oils. They are also found in lard, butter and coconuts. Walnuts are a great source of omega-6 fatty acids, providing about 11 grams of linoleic acid, as well as it contains alpha-linolenic acid, which is a plant-based omega-3 fatty acid. Recommendations regarding the essential omega fatty acids are quite different from conventional recommendations on essential nutrients. For the omega fatty acids, a balance of omega-6 and omega-3 fatty acids is best in the ratio of 2 to 1, which has to be maintained. The importance of omega-6 fatty acids. Omega-6 fatty acids have been found to help in reducing nerve pain. Studies show that taking gamma-linolenic acid or GLA, which is a type of omega-6 fatty acid, for a period of 6 months or more may reduce the symptoms of nerve pain in people with diabetic neuropathy. People who have normal blood sugar control may find GLA more effective than those with poor blood sugar control. Omega-6 fatty acid, like omega-3, fights inflammation. Eating healthy fats like PUFAs generally have a positive effect on health. GLA produced in the body from linoleic acid is metabolized to DGLA, which makes it an anti-inflammatory nutrient. Omega-6 helps in reducing symptoms of ADHD or attention deficit hyperactive disorder. Studies have suggested that omega-3 and omega-6 fatty acids helps in improving the symptoms with attention deficit hyperactivity disorder individuals. Omega-6 also reduces high blood pressure and therefore lowers the risk of heart disease. GLA alone or combined with omega-3 fish oil may help in reducing high blood pressure symptoms. The American Heart Association suggests that linoleic acid may decrease the risk of coronary heart disease. By substituting vegetable oils rich in PUFAs instead of using saturated fats, heart diseases can be prevented. Now, very interestingly, omega-6 supports bone health. Studies indicate that PUFAs may help preserve skeletal formation as aging progresses. Both men and women showed improvement in both the bones of the hips and the spine when taking omega-6 and omega-3 fats, showing that they can help in building bone health. Now, what happens with the deficiency of omega-6 fatty acid? Deficiencies of omega-6 essential fatty acids can lead to several clinical implications, including growth retardation, skin lesions, reproductive failure, fatty liver, and polydipsia. Fat-free diets may lead to essential fatty acid deficiencies and eventually death if the missing nutrient is not provided. There are many physiological complications that can occur from a dietary lack of omega-6 fatty acids. These include eczema or dry irritated skin, water loss, hair loss, drying eyes, arthritis and high cholesterol. More serious complications can lead to heart arrhythmias, infection and the inability to heal, kidney damage, sterility, growth problems, behavior problems, and miscarriages in pregnant mothers. What is the ratio of omega 6 and omega 3? Though the short chain fatty acids can be precursors to long chain fatty acids, it is easy when they are taken from dietary sources. The optimal omega 6 omega 3 ratio has been estimated to be 2:1 to 3:1, which is 4 times lower than the current intake, and it is therefore recommended that humans consume more omega 3 fatty acids from vegetable and marine sources. Flaxseed contains 57%, canola has 8%, and soybean has 7% of omega 3 fatty acids. Cod liver oil, mackerel, salmon, and sardines, as well as crab and oysters, are good sources of long chain fatty acids. Dear student, so far you have seen that omega 3 and omega 6 fatty acids are important essential fatty acids and can be taken only from our dietary sources. So it is very essential and important that an individual includes a lot of omega 3 and omega 6 fatty acids, which can be obtained from vegetable oils and fish in general. You must have seen a lot of other sources so far, but I want you to remember that essential fatty acids are very important and are associated with one's mental health. So children who are growing, adolescents who are learning, adults who are associated with lot of brain work, and elderly people to stop their aging process require lot of omega 3 and omega 6 fatty acids as functional foods. So concluding, let me tell you that fatty acids are essential components of our nutritional requirements and have to be obtained from dietary sources, and hence a judicious addition of these in our daily diet can lead to a healthier life. Thank you.